back here. Puppy mills are, and again, this is very quick, and I have some websites for you at the end if you want to read more, and I really encourage you to do that. But they're large-scale commercial breeders, and their main goal is not to improve the breed, not to make sure the puppies are healthy and happy, but to make money. Now, everybody needs to make money. You know, Enza and I get paid for what we do. I'm sure your teachers get paid for what they do. Your parents get paid. So we all need to make money. There's nothing wrong with that. But to make money by mistreating animals and caring very poorly for animals in our society, we don't feel is acceptable. But that's what puppy mills do. They just want to make money and they don't really care about the animals that they use to make money. So little concern for the quality of the breeding stock, and by that I mean the mom and the dad dogs. Very little concern for the puppies. They don't take good care of the puppies once they're born. Dogs are kept under very poor conditions, like we just saw. They don't get much health care. They get poor quality food. And when they aren't able to keep producing puppies, then the breeders don't want them anymore. They're of no use to them. Puppies like this are primarily bred for pet stores. So it's important to know that, because one of the ways to reduce the incidence of puppy mills is not to support the sale of puppies through pet stores. We get into our program, with my time, I need to be...
You have about 15 minutes.
Okay, I'm going to go a little faster. We get dogs into our program who have been used for breeding in puppy mills and then are no longer wanted. We call them puppy mill survivors or puppy mill breeder dogs. And this is a kind of the face of one of the dogs that came from our program, and you can see that it doesn't look very happy. Got kind of a vacant look in her eyes. When they come to us, these dogs are, I said before that one of the characteristics of Goldens is they love people. They want to be with people. You know, Sammy can't get enough of people. The dogs that come out of the puppy mills, not true of them. They're afraid of people. They've had bad experiences with people. They've been handled roughly. So they don't want anything to do with people. They will run away or hunker down if you come near them and try to touch them. They're very sad to see it.
There's one thing though, when I first started dealing with puppy mill dogs, I just assumed that since they weren't socialized, that they were going to be vicious towards us, and they're not. They're very afraid. They very rarely, or I don't really know of any of them that have really tried to bite. They are just scared. So we do have a big success in rehabilitating the dog. Those are sure done.
Thank you very much. That's a very good point, and so that they're scared, but they're not vicious. They're not vicious. They don't bite or attack. They're just scared.
Leave you all, please.
They've never lived in a home, so they have no idea what to expect if they go into a home. They generally haven't ridden in cars, or if they have, it's been a bad experience. They often haven't walked on grass before. So they're very, very different than your normal golden retriever. But we can help them. And we started a program about 3 years ago now called Project Home Life. Now, we were already working with these kinds of dogs, but we wanted to make it a little bit more formal and really help them acclimate better and learn, gain confidence, and learn what it's like to live in a house before they go into a house. And I want to say that I've been with Dvgrr on staff now for 5.5 years, and I've seen a huge number of these type of dogs come into the program and go into homes. And well, it's very, very sad to see them when they first come in and how scared they are. They really can improve. Some of them never get to the point of being as socialized as a non-puppy mill dog, but many of them become very friendly, very affectionate, very comfortable living in the house. So it's quite a transition. But we want to make it easier for them. So we started this program, and basically we use volunteers to help work with the dogs while they are in our care to help them get more comfortable with people, help them get more comfortable with things that they're going to see in a house, a doorbell, a dishwasher, a hairdryer, a washer dryer.